Hello guys, welcome to our channel. My name is Priyank. His name is Fennel. Today Fennel is not there in the house. He has gone somewhere else for some meeting. Today I am all alone and making this video for you guys. So why I am making this video is because this is an important discussion which needs to be done. This is an important topic which needs to be addressed. So that's why I am making this video. Now, the very important news, very important topic which I'm gonna start is, so guys, on 10th of July, Supreme Court is going to hear all petitions, review all the petitions with regards to same-sex marriage, which in 2023, the Supreme Court could not give a decision in favor of the community, though Supreme Court has mentioned that they understand the pain which the people from the LGBTQIA+ community goes through. So in today's video, hum kya discuss karne wale hain? Hum discuss karne wale hain what is this LGBTQIA+ all about, and why are LGBTQIA+ community is asking for the marriage and equal rights, and what is the social opinion on that, and how I personally feel being a part of this community. So all these things which we are gonna discuss in this video, aur last tak bani rahiyega, aur I would like to thank all of you for supporting us, always be there for us. So thanks a lot. So bina samay waste karte hue start karte hain hum ye video. Okay, so guys, सबसे पहली चीज है, what is LGBTQIA+ community? Why this topic is all about? Why this is coming? You know, so see, obviously most of you people know what LGBTQIA+ is, but then a lot of people also doesn't have a fair idea about this community, right? So there are different kind of people with different kind of sexual orientation, and a man can love a man, a woman can love a woman, and a man can love both a man and a woman, or vice versa. So there are different sort of the orientation. So now, what is the most prevalent orientation in human beings is heterosexual, right? So this is what we have seen throughout our lives, that a man loves a woman, or a woman loves a man, and they get married, right? So this is what we have seen. But now the point is that there are people with same sex, you know, they are attracted to the similar sex. So now in that particular situation, a person has decided that he wants to be with another person, he wants to spend rest of his life with another person who is of the same. So people from this community has to face two issues. One is the society and the other one is the legality. Now the one good thing which I would like to say here is, in 2018 September, Supreme Court has decriminalized Section 377. So which basically means that after 2018, if a man is being physical with another man and both of them are adults and having mutual, I mean it's mutual basically, so then it's not a crime anymore. You know, इससे पहले तो it was a crime. I mean, then Supreme Court said that it should not be our business what you guys are doing inside your bedroom. Then Supreme Court said that we apologize for all of the discrimination which you guys have to go through, and you know, the way the other people sees you, the way the other people discriminates. So that is something we are sympathetic and empathetic about. Now the point is that we understand what LGBTQIA+ community is. Now we understand that being physical with same sex is not illegal anymore. So why people are asking for marriage to Supreme Court? Why they are going and asking ki bhai hame shaadi ka adhikar? See, so the previous decision given by the Supreme Court of being physical is not crime anymore, that's a good step, I would say. But the point is that to spend a life only being physical is not everything, right? If I want to spend a life with someone, so I want it to be legally recognized. Now society doesn't accept you, legality wise, you are you know, your relationship doesn't carry any value. So deep inside, you feel that where do we stand? I mean, whatever I am earning, I pay equal taxes whatever a straight person would have been paying, right? If there is no discrimination in asking tax from me, so why is there a discrimination of making a law to let me marry whomsoever I want? So considering all these things, Supreme Court has decided to review all of the petitions which has come to this to them on 10th of July, because they also understand that it's high time each and every one should get equal rights. And obviously, when we talk about our Constitution, Article 21, so each and every person has the right to be equal in this democratic country. Now, next point I would like to mention here is, in 2023, when Supreme Court has given this decision, the Supreme Court said that we are sympathetic with you all, and but the thing is that we are not the one who has to take this decision. It is Parliament who has to decide, so we will not be able to give you what you want. The community as a whole, if it's not united, we will not be able to get what we deserve. And what we are asking for is not something which is way too much to be given. We are asking right to life and personal liberty, that's it. So we want to marry whomsoever we want to. And then there are a lot of things which are dependent upon it. Number one, for example, if I want to buy a home with my partner, now I will be able to say that yes, he is my partner. And if we have the same address, maybe me and my partner wants to update the address on the Aadhaar card, and let's say the house is in the name of one person only. So until unless we are legally spouse of each other, we will not be able to get the Aadhaar update for the other partner, right? And right of inheritance. So what happens is, something happens to one partner, the other partner doesn't have any right. So we all feel that these things needs to be considered, these things needs to be put light upon, and in coming few days, and we hope that Supreme Court should this time should give something which last time it was not given to us. So, and one more thing which I would like to mention, that in 2023 it has been said that this is an urban and elite concept of phenomena. Sorry to say, this is not a urban or elite phenomena. This exists everywhere in each and every species. But homophobic people are there in only one species, and that is human being. But what I would like to mention, that this is not an urban and elite. We are not very elite. We are not from very elite class. But still, we know what we are. We know what we like. We know. If we will choose something which this society wants, might lead to destruction of some girl's life. So why to take any decision of marrying someone where you do not have interest in? So all of us have all the rights of living, and we do no harm to anyone. We try to be as good as a normal straight person would be. So with all these words, I would like to say that let's hope for the best, let's cross our fingers, and let's see what happens. And stay tuned, and thank you for all your love which you have given us. And lots of love from Priyank and Fennel. Though Fennel is not there, but love is there. So yeah, love is love, guys. Take care, bye.